will the Earth perish in fire or in ice? In 5 billion years, say cosmologists, the planet will be burnt to a cinder. Our sun will exhaust its supply of hydrogen and begin to burn helium, growing into a red giant. The outer layer of the sun will envelop the Earth, reducing all life to ashes. This could lead one to ask, what might cause the world to end tomorrow? We may not have to wait 5 billion years before a lack of sunlight destroys all life on Earth. Like other yellow dwarf stars, our sun may enter a period of reduced activity, in which it becomes dimmer by almost 1%. This is enough to freeze solid even our saltwater oceans, along with every other thing on the surface of the planet. Astronomers have observed in distant galaxies the rare collision of two stars, which results in a deadly burst of gamma rays. If this ever happens anywhere in our Milky Way galaxy, it would strip the ozone layer from Earth's atmosphere. Unfiltered ultraviolet light from our own sun would kill off the organisms at the bottom of our food chain, including the plankton in the oceans. Eventually, every other living thing would starve to death or die from skin cancer. At CERN in France, with its Large Hadron Collider, routine scientific experiments in particle acceleration could result in the accidental creation of a black hole. Even if minuscule in size, it will immediately begin to swallow all surrounding matter and grow until it has sucked up every atom of the planet, becoming a dark object about the size of a basketball. It will have the mass of the Earth and continue to orbit the Sun in its place. The black hole will have one satellite, the Moon, which will be the only place remaining with any physical trace of mankind. Nanotechnology is the building of very small machines, no bigger in size than a few atoms. It will enable us to treat sickness in the human body by injecting a person with nanobots to perform surgery on a patient from the inside. The danger is in programming these machines to replicate. If nanites ever escape the lab, they would spread through the air like floating pollen. Their reproduction unchecked and their population increasing exponentially, they could digest all living matter in the world. The influenza A virus may soon jump from infected birds to people. Avian flu will cover the globe like wildfire. In less than 1 year, more than 90% of the human population will be wiped out. Symptoms begin with fever and a pounding headache, succeeded rapidly by vomiting and the hemorrhagic failure of internal organs, including the lungs. Death typically follows within 24 to 48 hours. The latest goal of biological warfare is the genetic engineering of ethnic bioweapons, designed to seek out and eliminate the members of a particular ethnic group. An airborne version of this germ would bring about a second Holocaust, without the added expense of administrating concentration camps. today, there are more than 15,000 nuclear weapons worldwide in the arsenals of 9 different countries, one of which is North Korea. Even a limited nuclear exchange involving less than 100 missiles would raise enough dust in the stratosphere to drastically reduce sunlight for the next 25 years. However, it would only take 1 year for the biosphere to become so dark and cold that it would fail to support any form of agriculture. The extinction of 99% of the human race would be assured. Any list of apocalyptic disasters would be incomplete without a biblical reference. Even if you do not believe in the Sky Daddy, if there is a God, he still may have the power he used in the Old Testament to intervene one final time in the human experiment, perhaps to start over somewhere else. We'll be right back.